So today let's take a look at my cat and a box of old components. Here you can see some old high voltage capacitors up to 3 kilovolts, some old lamps, a box full of capacitors, and some other components. Here you can see some vacuum tubes, probably Soviet, some Soviet transistors here, a big crystal probably, some high voltage diodes made by Tesla and some Soviet ones, a limit switch from an elevator, another switch from an elevator with a roller here, and also a cat in the box now. That's nice. Here you can see some old crystals in metal cans. Here you can also see some old potentiometers here in the box. Some vibrating voltage inverter from some vacuum tube device because you didn't have any transistors back then. So this was an inverter for vacuum tubes for the anodes if the device was operated using a battery, probably. Here you can see some old lamps and some panel meter, some mechanical counter, and here you can see some glass crystals, which are quite interesting, very nice. There is some lightning arrestor or lightning protection up to 5 kiloamps. That's nice, that's a lot of current. And here you can see some other panel meters, some current meter, voltage meter, a Soviet panel meter, very nice. And most importantly, this frequency meter, which is just absolutely amazing. So this is a full box of old crystals, metal crystals, plastic crystals. What's this? This is just amazing. Some metal crystals with a shielding actually. Other crystal, interesting. And those crystals, some crystal oscillator probably. And this is also interesting. I was initially thinking that this is a socket for a crystal, but it's not a socket, it's an actual crystal. 915 kHz, a Soviet crystal. And I also came across some old thermometers. Those measure in degrees Celsius and Reaumur. And this one only measures in degrees of Reaumur, which is quite amazing. It's like 100 years old or even more. And I also have some mechanical timer here, some contactor or relay. Execution realization, that's scary. It seems like an old contactor, maybe for some elevator or something like this. Looks interesting. Some non-sparking buzzer. So if you have a gas leakage, you don't blow up, basically, with a coil. And that's it. Some old thermostat here. In a nice packaging. It's brand new, but probably from 80s. It's from, I don't know. Let's try to open it. Here you can see some neon lamp, the thermostat with the contacts, and some calibration potentiometer, terminals, some switch, and that's more or less it. Here you can see the contacts. I also have some vintage oil filter for a car. And that's it. An oil filter and some other relay or contactor here. Nice. with a lot of contacts and some box of old capacitors and resistors, full packages of them basically, some other resistors. This is a package of 500 pieces, and that's crazy. Another package of resistors, 800 pieces. That's insane. And some old metal transistors like those, some in packages, and a heat sink for it, and a transistor on a heat sink, another one's on heat sinks, and of course a box of Soviet nixies, a lot of them. Those go into a socket, they have pins, and some discharge lamp, a mercury vapor discharge lamp producing ultraviolet light. It looks quite scary. It's for some suntan machine or something like this. And there is a set of vintage thermometers with a very nice box for them. Very interesting. Some old potentiometer in the original packaging. A double potentiometer. And some other nixies in the boxes. What's this? A nixie tube. Some ceramic tubes for transmitters. And a tiny vintage transformer. And here you can see some vacuum fluorescent displays. Some Geiger counter tubes. Another Geiger counter tube here. And here you can see some nixie. Another nixie here. And a xenon lamp. Does it come out? And this is a xenon lamp for a photographic flash. It was a flash for old analog cameras. And also some dekatrons, basically gas-filled tubes for counting. For some counters, frequency meters or computers with no semiconductors in them. In nice boxes, never opened. That's amazing. And amazingly, those Decatron tubes were produced in Soviet Union in 91. They kept making those until early 90s. Was it to have a computer that can survive a nuclear explosion or just to keep the people employed? And here you can see some vintage door opening mechanisms. With an electromagnet probably to open the door. It has terminals here, but it doesn't say any voltage. And also some telephone speakers or microphones. Full boxes, basically. And some Soviet neon lamps. And of course a spare CRT tube for an oscilloscope. With a socket, and of course a data sheet. From 1961. It's for this amazing machine. And of course some vintage 70s chips and sockets for them. So I can, for example, build a clock of just 70s components. So this is Darren Wild, and see you in my next videos, and thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support.
And in another video, I plan to take a closer look at this frequency meter. It's quite an amazing device.